By the end of this video, you'll be able to make a camera fly through 3D text effects inside DaVinci Resolve. So let's get right into it. So first of all, let me show you the B-roll without the 3D text. So as you can see, I have an aerial footage flying ahead, and this is one of the main things that make the effect look good. So the first thing we're gonna do is come to Effects, then Effects again, and drag and drop a fusion composition into our timeline. By default, it comes with a duration of 5 seconds, but let's make it a bit longer. We're gonna hit Command-D, and we're gonna make it 10 seconds long. Now, let's head over to Fusion. If you don't know what Fusion is, it's basically a compositing software, meaning that every kind of visual effect is made here. And Fusion is a node-based software. A node is basically a box like this one, which performs a specific effect or action. And as you can see here, we have many types of nodes. We have background nodes, text nodes, mask nodes, but today we're gonna be using the 3D nodes, which are these ones right here. So first things first, we're gonna close Inspector so we can better see our nodes here, and we're gonna grab this renderer 3D node, a merged 3D node, and we're gonna connect the output of our merge 3D into the input of the renderer 3D, like this. Now, we're gonna connect the renderer with our media out. And the media out is basically where everything we do here is being rendered into the final video. Okay, next, we're gonna drag and drop our footage into the node tree. We're gonna grab an image plane 3D, and we're gonna connect the output of our media 1 to the input of our image plane 3D, and the output of our image planner into the input of the merge 3D. And what this node does is basically transport our media 1, which is a 2D media, into the 3D space, which we can see if we drag and drop our merge 3D into the first viewer. Now, to better view what we're doing, let's leave viewer 1 with our merge 3D and our viewer 2 with our renderer 3D. So as we can see here, there are black stripes in our footage. Now, this may or may not happen to yours, but if it does, we're gonna click on the media 1 node, hit shift spacebar, and grab a transform node. Now, we're gonna bring back Inspector and increase the size a little bit, just so the stripes disappear. We can close our media pool now, and the next thing we're gonna do is grab a camera 3D and a text 3D. And we're gonna connect both into the merge 3D, like this. Now everything disappeared, and if you see here in viewer 1, it's because our camera is just past the image. So what we're gonna do is bring it back, and we can do that by dragging this blue cone here, like this. Now it's a bit too much, let's go back. There you go, now we're gonna write our text. Let's adjust it to the middle of the screen, and it looks weird, and that's also because it's past the image, so we're gonna have to bring it back as well. And we can do that either by dragging this blue cone over here, or by coming to transform and rolling the z-axis in the translation property, like this. Let's bring it a little bit more, like this. Let's come back to the main settings and make it smaller, adjusting the size, like this. And if we look here at viewer 1, it actually looks like a 2D text. So for us to really get the 3D popping, we have to come to extrusion and drag this little circle right here at extrusion depth a little bit to the right, like this is fine. Now let's give it some texture. And for that, we're gonna select our text 3D. We're gonna hit shift spacebar and grab this replace material 3D. Now we're gonna come to effects, templates, fusion, and shaders, and here you can find many textures, and it's a very simple thing to do. All I have to do is drag and drop a texture, and then connect it to this green input right here. And as you can see, there's this brick texture, you can also use a wood texture, and you can play around and see what fits you best. But the one I like most for this effect is this one right here, chrome. And to make it a little less bright, we can come to diffuse color and make it a little darker, like this. Now, we're almost there. Let's close the effects, and let's only leave viewer 2 visible. And you can do that by clicking on this button right here. Let's make it fit to screen, and now we're gonna give it some movement. So what we have to do is select the text node, and making sure we're at the beginning of the timeline, here at frame 0, we're gonna come to transform and set a keyframe on the X, Y, and Z axis of the translation property, like this. Now we're gonna come to frame 140, and we're gonna adjust the movement, like this. And we're gonna fly through the letter D. Now let's go back to the edit page, and let's see how it looks. And if you like this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel, and let me know in the comments below what types of videos you want me to make. And if you want to learn other editing tricks and hacks inside DaVinci Resolve, make sure to check out this video showing on your screen right now, and I'll see you there.